Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. Let's talk today about home improvements from a real estate agent's vantage point that represents buyers and sellers. Where is the biggest payoff going to be for you? We did a slideshare presentation recently that basically kind of like a PowerPoint presentation that is online that talked about the four largest home improvement or the four home improvement projects that have the largest return. First place we're going to stop today on our home improvement journey, getting your house either ready to sell or just trying to improve its value in the best way possible, let's talk about the kitchen. People like upgraded kitchens. So that's a very good starting point. Could be granite, could be concrete, could be Corian, could be some kind of a fancy type countertop. Could be a full backsplash with outlets installed, maybe extras, of course, away from the sink. The island should have special attention paid to it if you have one. If you don't have one, maybe an option to put one in. There might be. In fact, you might be able to put seating under the island as well, which makes the kitchen now become more of the home's focal point. Of course, cabinet space can't ever have enough. Very nice appliances, everything clean, Q-tip clean, of course, if you're going to be listing your house on the market. And the kitchen cabinets and the counters, perfect rendition would be if they actually flowed through the home and matched the bathrooms. So moving into the kitchen, let me give you some numbers. People that put in the right things in the kitchen got a 60 to 120% return on investment. So let's talk about bathrooms. That's a very critical part. The kitchen kind of flows in there, so you have the countertops in the kitchen that match the countertops in the bathroom. That's cool. And then the cabinetry in the kitchen that also matches the bathrooms. But again, just having that bathroom show-ready condition, having that bathroom really, really nicely upgraded, so the new cabinets, the doors not falling off the hinges, the water damage, all of that cleaned up. If in fact your bathtub has rust spots in the bottom of it from the plaster or the covering chipping away, if you have issues in your sink, bad old fixtures in your bathroom, and laminate flooring, maybe those are things to hit. Now let's talk about those numbers. 80 to 130% return on investment for people that did bathroom upgrades. Adding square footage, that's also something that does benefit, but you have to do it in the right way, and in fact, you have to know where to go. So if you have a smaller than average size living room, maybe that's the place you need to start looking as far as expansion. As far as additional bedrooms and bathrooms, my suggestion to you before undergoing any kind of renovation project, call your local agent and find out how much more a four-bedroom home in your neighborhood is selling for than, let's say, yours is a three-bedroom home. What is that difference? And then you'll be able to find out if that's the best place for you to be. The next step with regard to that room addition or adding square footage would be then to moving into deck and a patio on your particular property. So if in fact you have a concrete slab but there's no covering, it might be a good option to add that. Now I do know that in our local real estate market, people ask from time to time if in fact those decks and patios have been permitted with the city. So wherever you are out here in our neck of the woods or somewhere else, call up the city and find out if it is necessary for you to have those types of things permitted. Because I'll tell you, they give you a 65 to 90% return on investment for a deck and a patio when it comes to buyers out there, at least in the current market. So contact your agent when you have a chance. Ask them the best place to put their money or the best place for you to put your money in reference to your home improvement projects. I'm Connor with Honor, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. It's a pleasure, and I'm sure we'll talk to you soon. Thanks.